Hello, guys, and welcome to race number 14 of the season here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. This is the last race in the Cup Series before we head over to the All-Star Race over at Coca-Cola Super Speedway, where this is going to be quite an interesting race. We had a wild, and I mean wild, Xfinity race. We've had cars racing hard, three wide, four wide, into catch fences and walls, you name it, after the Xfinity race. And now we're here for the Cup race, where even more exciting stuff can happen. Join me in the broadcast booth. He is a good friend of mine. He's getting back into the offline community, and more importantly, he's going to try to see if we see someone maybe get a good flip or two. Please welcome Zach Rogers. How you doing, man?
What's up, Bulldog? Speed is back, and we're here at Vegas.
Now, I got to ask you, Zach, this is probably one of your favorite tracks I've heard in the offline community that you've seen.
Well, you can either have good racing, you're going to have bad racing. It really depends. What the package is going into the race. We've seen people get three wide here, four wide. I forget what season it was, but in Voltage Cup, we had a finish one season here. They were three wide coming out of turn four, and the top three that were three wide wrecked out of the corner, and fourth place or fifth place, whoever it was on the bottom, got by for the win. That finish was insane. Hopefully we'll see something crazy like that here again today.
So we're going to go through the top 10 lineup here, presented by ESPN. Steven Pollard III gets the pole for today's race. Second is Kyle Miller. Third is William Duncan. Fourth, Kev Shear. Fifth, Zachary Fitzwater. Sixth, James Qualls. Seventh, Kevin Becker. Eighth, Sky Commons. Ninth is Ian Duck. In the top 10 is Ainge Nafarro. And here's the rest of your lineup from 11th on back. Now, like I mentioned, this is the last race before the All-Star race. This is the last chance for some drivers that don't have a win this season and never got a win last season to get over and get this win. So how much pressure do you think that is, Zach, for these drivers?
Well, they might want to win that $1 million, have a chance at that $1 million. I mean, it's got to be some pressure, but, I mean, if they don't really care for it, maybe they just want to get in the chase here.
On the final row, we have Keith Batson and Connor Meyer. So top 10 we'll explain in just a bit there because we're going to get the command there. But I'll tell you something, though. 10th place is a battle between Steven Pollard III and Kyle Matthews. If Pollard did not get that win, we would have a dead tie for 10th. Here's the command. And here's the command. We're going to quickly tell you the top 10 points. Brett Pritchard is the points leader. Clint Spillman second. Gardner third. Bryant fourth. Walton fifth. Navarro sixth. Bishop seventh. Zach Rogers in eighth. Dylan Poteet ninth. And like I mentioned, Pollard III is 10th. And then you got Matthews, Washer, Richie, Barber, Commons, Curtis, Fitzwater, William Duncan, just outside the top 10. They need a good finish. So the pace car is rolling on off with its drivers there. All 42 are going. Zach, I got to ask you, this is a great field. Who do you think is going to take the W today?
Oh, I can't predict that. It's 41 laps of racing. It's the Russian roulette of tracks. Can you roll all three sevens? Who's going to get lucky in Vegas?
Green flag is out underway here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, and a great start by Steven Pollard III. He got going.
Yeah, he got going, and the 55 right behind them got going, too.
43 Kyle Miller got caught sleeping right there, and the Air Force Ford already falling to the back. And what we've seen in the Outback race was a lot of three-wide racing. Well, more of the three-wide, making sure everyone's all right until halfway through. Things start go for the worse as Pollard III will lead the first lap. One guy that's going to want big redemption is Zachary Fitzwater. He went into the catch fence. That was an unbelievable wreck. And I'm amazed he's actually still driving this race alone. And I got to ask you, I mean, Las Vegas and its history, there's been a lot of crazy wrecks and there's been a lot of hard hits. And how do you even get that as a driver to take a hard hit and even get back on the track the next day? That's unbelievable.
Well, it's obviously got to be a lot of perseverance and willpower to be able to get back in the car after such a nasty hit. But the safety that this series has given to these drivers in these race cars is almost non-matchable. And it's just provable that when you don't have any fatalities in these series and people don't even really get hurt, that there's a lot of safety going on as they are three wide for the race lead coming
Bishop
to lap four.
Barely, wow. He barely got ahead of Duncan there. And now here comes Levi McIntyre in the 19, the Aris Toyota there. And McIntyre's had not bad of a season so far. He's still looking for that win to get into that All-Star race. But, like, you know, like I mentioned, a lot of pressure for these drivers, though.
Yeah, and this is definitely going to seem to be probably one of the tracks where you want to be on the bottom. And there's a yellow.
As RJ Bishop leads to the line. As trouble for Angel Navarro in the 25 Taco Bell car.
That car's smoking. They're done. You can just tell by looking at it.
Kyle Matthews, that's 11th in points. That is going to really hurt the 09 there. And we may have to see him in the showdown. Oh, Sky Commons, the hometown hero for this race. I forgot to mention. Oh, no.
That 24's done.
Looks like a wreck happened on turn two. As you see the skid marks. Looks like everybody else is okay for the moment.
It looks like it might have just been a 3 or 4 car incident here. I'm not seeing damage from anybody else. It might have happened at the back of the field.
Caution is out. No one's coming down pit road except for the damaged cars, but RJ Bishop is the leader. Let's go take a look what happened on turn two to bring ourselves our first caution for today's race. So we're taking a look at what happened here. They just entered three wide, and you keep an eye on the 09 and 25 right there. Kyle Matthews gets a good run on the corner and just gets a little too hot. Kind of squeezes Navarro into Sky Commons, and then watch the 09. He's going to take a good little hit right here. Watch the whiplash.
Yeah, he got whipped around hard, and it looked like the 09 did drift up a little, but the 25 didn't cut him any slack either, and then the 24 came down on him too, but the 09 and 25 were already drifting up the track, and Sky Commons just had nowhere to go. But the 09 got whipped around.
Well, what was crazier too is that was only a 3-car incident, but you take a look at the 09, and we're going to show you in fast motion. I mean, because that was a slow motion view. Watching full motion the 09, watch the full motion view of the 09. You can tell how fast that whiplash is. Yeah, he took a good little shot there, and that car whipped around pretty quick.
I'm curious what happened to the 24, because we know the 24 was down pit road, but from what we're seeing, he didn't travel as far as the other two, and he might have got hit by somebody else there. There might have been somebody else involved in this, because I'm pretty sure I just saw him get hit.
Yeah, let's take a look at another view here. Let's see if we can go to the spectator view. That's not a good view. Let's take a look in the helicopter and see what we can find here.
These guys were right in the middle of the field in 20th.
Wow, Trent Dunham almost got hit right there, and same with this. Zach Rogers got close, too. And
nobody hits him here. Oh, he just bounces off the wall again, maybe. Yeah.
Connor Meyer's going to also avoid that one, too. So
that's close.
Yeah, no one else hit him. It was just really a 3-car incident. But I'm amazed, though, that
you got to give props that none of those guys really bounced right off the wall back down the track. Yes. If they did, you would have had at least a 10-car, maybe 7-car pileup.
Yeah, and we had that, too, in the Xfinity race, where they came right back down into traffic. And unfortunately, they just had nowhere to go. But we're going to take a quick onboard of Kyle Matthews and show you that view that he had of that crash. On board Kyle Matthews, take a look at his view. Yeah, it was just a good run and just didn't work. How's it look?
Still
what happened?
Completely incredible. That was a 3-car pileup.
Yeah, that amazes me too. Caution's out for the first time today. Let's go take you back to the green. Lights on the pace car are off. As Pacers are getting this one lap to go. Drivers out of the race after that incident include Sky Commons, the hometown hero. Sadly, he will end up retiring dead last. And Angel Navarro with the camshaft issue. They are both out. Kyle Matthews got his car repaired. And he is now, back on the field. So, here's your top 10 rundown. RJ Bishop is the leader. Second is Levi McIntyre. Third, William Duncan. Fourth, Cody Lamas. Fifth, Stephen Potter. Third, sixth, Jessica Sheldon. Seventh, Anthony Ritchie. Eighth, DJ Curtis. Ninth, Ian Dedek. We're in the top 10, Clint Spillman. That's a great pick for Potter III, who was tied with Matthews at that point. And now he will be very lucky that Matthews is going to be off the pace. 11th through 20th is Devin Becker, Alex May, Zachary Fitzbar, Kyle Miller, Kev Shear, James Qualls, Trent Dunham, Dylan Pote, Paul Barber, and Alex Ferranti in the top 20. Good run for Alex so far. As pace cars on down the pit road, green flag back underway here at Las Vegas. Now, hopefully these guys won't go crazy on the three-wide, but right now they're single file. But when do you see the first set of cars, take a dive going for position?
It's a draft. The draft kicks in, and right off the corner.
They went all around the leader with the exception of DJ Curtis. They said, it's time to go.
That's 6 cars, second to 7th, just pulled out, and the 91 can say goodbye to his top 5 position.
Leading at the line, McIntyre over Duncan. And we've got a report from the 51 that he has actually blown a gear. He actually blew a gear, and now he's behind the pack, so he's off the pace. So that's not good for the Lee Filter Toyota there, but that's also one of his new schemes, too, that he has this season. So that's really not a good thing for that 51 team. Through the rest of the pack here. So far, it is a little spread out, but they are racing really well here. And I'll tell you what, Las Vegas still provides good racing. Wow, Pollard the third got a little too close to Richie, and he somehow kept his car together. Tight three wide racing.
They'll get really close here, but as we saw, if you get too close on the three wide in the wrong spots, you will wreck. And luckily, that first one was only a three car pilot, but I don't think we're done wrecking yet.
Oh, no.
We still got 30 to go, and it's going to get crazy soon. And it's probably going to happen in turn one again.
Yeah, the way how these guys are racing, it wouldn't be not be a surprise. Richie checked out from Devin Becker there. He just took a runaway there, and I think the 98 let off the throttle a bit.
Holy crap, the 5 got the turbo boost.
Yeah, he's gone. That Time Warner Cable Chevrolet said sayonara, and he's going out and checking away from the field as he'll lead another lap right here. So far, though, we are still green, and we're seeing a lot of 2 and 3 wide, but primarily 2. And you think 3 wide, is that really a good idea at this track, or is that too risky?
Oh, you can make it work if you're smart, but if you do it in the wrong spot, particularly entering turn 1, it can be tricky if you don't give the guy on the bottom enough room.
Here's another three-wide battle. That's Mason Powers in the high line, Jackie Tang in the middle, Zach Flickinger, the rookie, down low. Tang really lost some ground right there, and I think he's going to let the 8 on by, and, oh, wow, nearly got in the corner, but he does, though. Smart move by the Peak Toyota right there.
Yeah, and the 81 and the 8 were actually rubbing doors through the trial. Well, I don't know if anybody else caught sight of that, but that was kind of close call right there.
Yeah, these guys will provide some good tight racing there. And I'm amazed, though, just how these guys are able to race so close, and they're just running away. We got a new leader. That is Alex May in the 18. They just bumped coming into turn one. A couple of cars were bouncing off each other, and they somehow kept together. And now Reggie, he wants the lead right back. No, Trent Dunham tries a crossover move, and it's going to work. Nice move by the Sonic All-Stars Dodge there. Wow, that's unbelievable. Oh, trouble, Stephen Pollard, the third around. And, oh, Cody Lamas riding the wall. Fitzwater, yes. Tanner Sullivan. And, wow, Cody Lamas just rode the wall there.
Pretty big wreck right there. Coming
caution
the
down
line.
For the second time as these guys are racing back to the line. Jessica Sheldon. What happened to Kev Shearer? Shearer just wrecked.
There might have been another wreck. And the pace car is flooring it up here They took the yellow.
And now they're coming down the pit road. I think as they just crossed the stripe when that happened, and I think the 2 just hit the wall again. Oh, what is Becker doing? Oh, my God.
It was definitely
he just plowed into Jackie Tang.
Wow.
What are these guys doing?
They took the yellow sliding across the line, and it's confusion here. It's mass confusion.
They're doing pit stops right now, but Becker is on pit road. His day is over.
That's disappointing.
Yeah, looking on down here, that's our finish line. We're going to take a look at pit lane. Well, let's actually look at the TV2 here. Kev Shearer, remember, he got involved in a little late caution. I think he got into Jessica Shelton, and it looks like Dunham is going to lead him off pit road. Pollard the third, the pole sitter to this race, more trouble for him. Wow, 3 wide off exiting pit road there. They're going to have some extensive work on that 77 as Duncan just bounced off into him. There's Fitzwater. He's got rear-end damage, and now the 77 is going to go away. That was probably 3 wrecks in 1, but wow, Cody Lamas, though. He rode the outside wall on the front straight. I have not seen that at Vegas before. That's a pretty unbelievable wreck right there. Trent Dunham is the leader. Let's go take a look and for ourselves our second caution for today's race. They have given a red flag to this incident right here, but take a look at this. I mean, this was unbelievable. Watch the 48 and the 90 and the 98 there. You're going to see how really tight this 3 wide is. And then Cody just kind of leans on the corner, and then watch Becker just slide down in front of Zach Flickinger right here. Goes into Pollard. Amazing enough, the 8 does not get involved in this accident. I don't know how he avoids this. Watch Cody, though. gets hit from Pauly the third, and then just pulls a Martin Truex Jr. and rides the wall, except nearly the entire front stretch.
That's absolutely incredible.
Zachary Pitswar, there's McCurry and Tanner Sullivan. That's where they get involved. McCurry just jacked the 16. Now, this is where it gets really interesting here. I had a bad lag spike right there, which I apologize there. Keep an eye on when we go to Jessica Sheldon and catch you. Now, the caution comes out. These guys are actually slowing down. Keep in mind they're trying to slow because they just crossed the line when this happened. It's just totally shocked to these guys. Jessica Sheldon turns Kev Sheeran to 77. Now, Sheldon accidentally turns to 77. But watch Kev, though. This is on him. Slides around once. Just about has it saved. Then the car's going to take a dip, you're going to see, right here. And he's going to hit this inside wall. And this is where he gets his one and only bit of damage, right there. He just about avoided that accident. He just runs right into the wall.
I'm not seeing much door damage from it, but it could have some aerodynamic effects here.
And the last one we got to go up is Devin Becker, because I still don't know what he was thinking at this time. Now remember, he got wrecked, and he's coming back to the line. I mean, shouldn't you slow down at this point when you try to catch up to the field? Look at the speed. 146. And he's going around some of the guys that are really going like 20 miles an hour here. And then you just see his speed. Now it's really going down. And then just it's way too late. Runs right into Jackie Tang.
I think the big problem here was his Becker technically crossed the start-finish line in 20th when that accident occurred. And these guys were all slow because they were trying to let people get in their right spots. And Becker went low to avoid them, and there was already a car on the apron, and he just there was nothing he could do, and he just ended his race, which is got to be disappointing.
Yeah. So we're going to take a couple onboards of this wreck here, and then we'll take you back to the green. Onboard the NOS 4 to Devin Becker. Take a look at his view. It bounced around a bit, and he's actually not too badly damaged at this point, if you really think about it.
Yeah, like I said, though, you know, he's spinning out in that wreck 20th. He crossed the line backwards in 20th, and that's why he races back up. And you're going to see again that when he goes low on the apron, there's just nothing for him to do. He was going too fast of catching back up because those guys were going so quick. And the pace car had to jump up there.
You just see Jackie Tang right there, too. He also dived below because he thinks someone's going to plow in. Well, he doesn't know. He's the one getting plowed right there.
And that ended both their races. That was hard contact.
Yeah, Paul Barber almost got involved in that one, too. He just about avoided the 98. He got so close there. So we'll take one last view. We're going to go on board the 48. On board, Cody Lamas. Hope you like going sideways. This is going to be fun. I don't think he really expected to ride that wall, too, if you really think about it.
Yeah, he rode the wall for the good part of the straightaway there and came back down on all fours when Tanner Sullivan was on his left side.
And lucky break, too, for Cody. He really didn't get a lot of damage for that, so I think he could be not too badly off the pace there if he isn't.
Oh, anytime you ride the wall, you're going to get some kind of damage.
Yeah, so caution's out. Let's go take you back to the green. Lights on top of the pace car is out. Tanner Sullivan is a lap down the Miller in the, or why say Miller, Mountain Dew Ford. Cars out of the race include the following as Kyle Matthews had a piston problem in the 09, so he is already out of it. Really didn't help his cause. Devin Becker, Anthony McCurry, and Jackie Tang had a fuel problem. They are out of the race. I still don't know how Kyle Matthews had a piston problem, but I guess we got word that after the pit stop, he blew a motor and the piston was done, so not a good thing for Kyle Matthews, though. His chance to make the All-Star race are slim now. Top 10 rundown is Trent Dunham, Alex May, Levi McIntyre, Anthony Ritchie, Jessica Sheldon, James Qualls, Mason Powers, Ian Dennis, Zach Flickinger, RJ Bishop in the top 10. So the pace car is back down the pit road as we're about ready to go back to green. We're at the halfway point of this race, and I'm amazed that we really haven't had the big crash yet as green flag's back underway.
Yeah, that was kind of a big wreck, and the fact that somebody got on their side, but there was not a lot of cars involved in that.
Yeah, Tanner Sullivan, you could see in that Ford right there, he's already being a problem to these drivers on the inside line, and I don't know why he's going to the outside really get out of the way, but oh, DJ Curtis, he tried right there, and it did not work to his favor, and you could tell these guys are just trying to get around the Miller, or why can't see Miller, like, Mountie Ford's cars are coming down pit road. That's Zach Rogers, Alex May, Kyle Keith, and I don't know why these drivers are coming down pit road when they had pit stops earlier.
Yeah, it's definitely a confuser, but more importantly, they're three wide up there for the lead again.
Checking through, I guess that was all of it, even though there's some now separated from the pack.
As they're just taking a little gas. They might be just trying to go green all the way here, and that might be some strategy call.
Jessica Shelton
for the lead, though.
One of the few drivers this season to win in both series, and she's having such a season in Xfinity driving the 20, but in the 02 has been another story. And she has just been so impressive. Actually, both series, I believe, she's in the top 10 in points. So really nice effort by that 02 team, let alone for being in both series. It's three wide, James Qualls, he stuck his nose in there at the line. Wow, imagine it. That was the finish. Zach Flickinger just edged out Qualls and Shelton. Normally, you don't see the middle take the advantage heading to the start-finish line. But right now, it looks like it's an eight-car separation, and about ninth place, DJ Curtis is just behind, and Dylan Boteet's in the top ten, and then there's a big gap where Zachary Fitzwater is, and then everyone else who really got behind from these cars that went down pit road, and you can tell Tanner Sullivan, he really caused a problem. It looks like where Kyle Keith is, he's 31st. Looks like about six cars really had a pit stop there. And anybody else go lap down? All those drivers there. Ones who really got lapped down were Alex May, Trent Dunham, Al Keith, Austin Mungle, Zach Rogers, Caleb Harris, Keith Batson, and Michael Norman. All those guys are lapped down. Man, these drivers are now. We got a 10-car battle for the lead. How about Fitzwater? He's 11. Keep in mind, he's got rear-end damage. He's actually somewhat trying to get into that pack. Crown Royal Ford trying to really get on up there toward the front of the field. But Zach Flickinger, I can guarantee you, that's probably going to be the one car to beat this race. And that Brandon Dodge right there. Three wide for the lead yet again. Ian Dutta now taking the top spot. And I'll tell you, there's been a lot of swap for the lead. It's like a super speedway race gone into a very weird passion right here. Now Ian Dutta in the 32 in the outer wall Chevrolet. Now going to the lead. You got two Tweenex guys in this battle. You got a second Keith car. Then you got a couple of single car teams. You got MWR. You got a Hendrick car. You got a Stuart Haas car. You got for RJ Bishop for Bishop Incorporated. And a car for Retro Racing Enterprises, all in this pack alone. These guys are really just putting on a show today.
It's starting to heat up there.
Uh-oh, Pollard.
Oh, no. Oh, boy.
Oh, Richie. Whoa. And the old Poti nearly turned him.
And Pollard is blocking the lead pack now. This makes things crazy.
Anthony and Ritchie, Ian Dutta, they're running away. And I think Fitzwater, he's really trying to catch the pack. Oh, whoa, these guys really caught Fitzwater. Where did this second pack come from?
Well, they really had to slam on the brakes there, so I'm not surprised.
No, and McIntyre, he really got in a bad position, but now he got out of that call there. And Poti really is trying to get around that 06. He is not happy right there. Now, finally, these guys will break free.
Yeah, they're going to finally move the 06 up high. And
I wonder how bad that pack really. Oh, wow, that second pack just about caught up to him. And Sanford is now caught up to his teammate there, Jessica Sheldon. I thought I seen a car in the grass. Oh, he did. Trouble. Alex Ferranti into the wall hard. Oh, and Brett Pritchard, the points leader involved. Caution will wave. Anybody else going to hit him?
He's down low. I don't think anybody else is going to hit him. But this
wave, and that is not a good sign for a good number of drivers. They're racing back to the line as Richie will lead them down. I thought I did see a car go down. Kev Schuer actually turned the 29. He's down pit road, so now he's caught a lap down. What a lick for for Alex Ferranti. I'm amazed how the car's still driving, but wow, caution will wave. Where's the 49? Because I did see him get involved in that accident. Where is Brett Pritchard? Because he was the one that got into Alex Ferranti. That was scary of a crash. And there he is. He's coming down pit road, and he's out of it. Wow. That was just enough of a lick, and he retired out of the race. Another leaders are coming down pit road. Anybody else coming down pit road? That's not a good time for those drivers that are lapped down, and with less than 10 laps to go, this really changes the race for good.
It's going to be interesting.
Is the leader. The points leader also involved. That does not help one bit. Let's go take a look what happened to Alex Ferranti in car 29 and see what really caused this accident. So here's a look with ourselves, our third caution of today's race. Zach Fetzwater being a little bit of an issue there to Alex Ferranti. He's just trying to find a way to get around the Crown Royal Ford. And Kev Scherer just runs right into him. And Fetzwater somehow saves the car. But watch Alex Ferranti and watch Kev Scherer. Scherer actually makes a pit stop because of that, because he was in the commitment cone. Ferranti was not. And watch the 29. He just goes for a spin in the grass. And because there's no grip, he's just got no choice but to slide out.
Yeah, he can't help anything here. He's on the brakes trying to slow the car down. Right there, you can see the smoke come back up, but watch this hit here.
Driver's side.
Oh, right driver's side. The front end actually comes up off the ground, and then there are cars coming in.
Oh, wow, Pritchard. Trent Dunham actually almost got involved in that accident. That hit right there ended Pritchard's day, but Pritchard really didn't get a lot of damage from that. That's the shock.
You can see more cars splitting the 29 here. I mean, they're lucky they weren't in a huge pack, because that could have been a huge wreck with the 29 bouncing off the wall like that. But
he kind of
poked his nose in there, and then Fitzwater came back down on him, and that's what started the whole mess.
And also Kev Scherer being there at the same time, too. That really didn't help. Scherer made a pit stop. He said, screw it. But I'm amazed, though. Ferranti got more of the damage. And Pritchard, you can see in the car, he really doesn't have a lot of damage. You can see it easily, because this is the side where he got hit, the right side. It really doesn't look like he got hit at all, but I guess inside...
There was something must have broke, because as you can see, he went straight to the apron, and there's no smoke, but something must have broke on that car, because another suspension joint or something, but that right front got a pretty hard lick, because he never hit the brakes.
And our logic's striking again there. It's heading in its toll there, but caution is out for the third time today. A wild record, Alex Ferranti, but the leader, Anthony Ritchie, could he get his second win this season and his third career NRSL victory? We will see when we head back to green. Chase Garf's giving us the one lap to go. Kev Scherer is also out of the race in the 77, and the radiator had a problem for Brett Pritchard.
The radiator. There's your answer. The right side of the radiator must have got, like, piled in from some nose damage. And
this is the first time I've seen a radiator pop up on the retirees list. So I guess something new must happen in the NR, I guess.
Well, you tell me when you see that somebody retires from a fuel injector or something.
Oh, I've seen that before, too. Top 10 rundown real quickly is Ritchie, Flickinger, Dutta, Powers, Falls, Bishop, McIntyre, Poti, Curtis, and Jessica Shell in your top 10 is Paul Barber. Oh, he did not get going.
He either has damage or he did not go, but
no, he
remember,
does have that right.
10.
He does have that left side damage.
It's under 10 to go. Those lap down cars are restarting in the middle of the field, and this car definitely has some damage because he is holding up everybody.
That's behind
him. 12th on back.
And he's holding up his teammate. It's even worse, Trent Dunham. Oh, man.
They might wreck again here.
Oh, man, this is going to be chaotic. Tanner Sullivan coming down pit road. He almost just got clobbered.
It's
keep an eye
six
on Barber
laps to
here.
Go here. If they wreck again, this race will end in the yellow.
44.
And this is actually probably helping things a little bit. Is these guys get all single filed out, a less chance of them going three wide and wrecking. But it sucks for the guys that are trying to get up there for a win.
Yeah, these guys are really having problems there. Ferranti is Tanner Sullivan's leaving pit road. New leader, Ian Dunn of the 32. Looks like we have a 8-car breakaway. Jessica Shelton, 9, just trying to do what she can to get in the pack. And How about JT Bryan in 10th, though, just trying to do what he can, but he's in a good run. He's got left side damage, but he's hanging in there like a trooper. Up toward the front of the field. Two-car breakaway between Ian Dunn and RJ Bishop, who nearly turned each other.
They turned him down to the apron. They saved it.
Oh, my goodness. They nearly wrecked each other. That would have been bad. That would have ended the race just like that.
Matt, they would have come right back up in front of the rest of the leaders, and that would have been insane to see who might have made it through that.
Oh, that would have
been. But they're
going
to come to three to go, and Dutta and Bishop have actually pulled away from the rest of the pack.
I guess that helped them out. Third place still in Pozzi there. As I thought I seen the caution, but we are still green. Take a look.
There's
Sullivan
battle
back
for the
on
lead.
Track.
I think Dutta got pushed to the outside.
Get through here. Everybody looks like they're going to be okay. I doubt we'll see a caution unless a random wreck happens. But now
side
RJ
by side,
Bishop
here comes
going Pozzi. For the lead.
Poti's helping Ian Dutta out on the high line.
Yeah, Pozzi is helping his teammates.
But
a smart move, but now he's
going to
help Bishop.
Coming to two to go.
Going against Team Waters right
the
there.
Move? It's
going
to push Bishop to the lead. Oh, boy, here comes Pozzi now.
Here comes Jessica Shelton in the 0-2.
Shelton was in ninth place like two laps ago.
He's flying up to the front.
Here comes Richie. Richie trying to get back up to the lead.
Anthony Richie, what a turnaround he's had. And now he's in a really good position to try to get the win. Peter Sullivan, they just approached.
And that's going to hold up Pozzi and Shelton to the inside line coming
white
to the
flag.
White
flag.
But
oh
Sullivan
my
comes
goodness!
Back
now,
down and blocks
Tanner
her.
Is really not playing a factor here, and Pozzi is running away.
Goes up high. Bishop goes up high. Sullivan's going to hold up the 0-2. It's down to the 31 and the 91.
Shelton more problems with that car, really hurting her. Can Bishop get one last run on that 31 car? Here they come into turn number 3 and entering turn number 4. Dylan Pozzi trying
under.
To hold on in.
Another
slow car. Ferrante. Oh wow! But Pozzi's going to win the race.
Ruined. Bishop had
wow.
to slam the brakes.
Wow! Almost a troll moment there, but Pozzi just hangs on.
What a race finished. You damn lap cars.
Oh my goodness.
You screw people over, but you make it dramatic.
Hashtag dramatic lap cars. That's going to be trending in the NRSL world. But Dylan Pozzi is going to be victorious in this race in the Branch Chevrolet. The crazy thing about him is that he's entered that time where he could retire at the end of the season, but this is a big, big, big win for that 31 team, and I believe now he will be going to the All-Star race because of that win. What a finish. What a finish. And I can't believe I'm saying this. Zachary Fitzwater got a top 10 finish because of that.
Absolutely.
He had a damaged car, and he finished 10th.
Well, that's what happens when you had Tanner Sullivan
right.
held up the leaders coming to the white, and that blocked the low line. Some cars caught up, and then, I mean, it didn't. Ferrante didn't really hurt anybody but Bishop having a shot at getting underneath Pozzi.
He almost
I mean,
had
I think,
it, too.
I think
I
if Pozzi went high and Bishop went low, it could have been a photo finish because of Ferrante.
Yeah, let's take a look at that again. You can see right there, Bishop was looking low coming to the line. Well, at least off turn 4, and I didn't even expect Ferrante. I just seen him at the last second, and I'm like, uh-oh. And I think Bishop, you know, it's just a matter of luck with these lap cars, and Bishop went high, Pozzi down low. Pozzi knew once he got down low and Ferrante wasn't going to block him, he knew he got that race won.
I'll be honest, Bishop was so close to the back of Pozzi that I'm not sure he even saw Ferrante until Pozzi decided to just jerk it down on him.
No.
I think Bishop was expecting Pozzi to hold high a little longer. And he was going to make the move and make it a close finish.
You take a look in the cockpit view, you're going to see right here. Yeah, he actually gets a good view of that 29 car you're going to see. But if you take
a look.
He can
see him. He sees him right here. But, you know, Pozzi, he tries to get all the run off he can.
Yeah, you could tell. He was wanting to go down low. He was ready to go down low. But then when you see the 29, Pozzi knew right away, I'm going
to
go low.
Pozzi brake checked him the slightest bit. And pulled down, and then Bishop had to slam the brakes for Ferrante.
Yeah, although Bishop still finished second, but man, what a race though that was. Holy cow. It's a veteran teaching a rookie new tricks there. What a finish right there. That was unbelievable. And I'm still awestruck. I really am. So that was a great finish though, nonetheless. So because of that, they're now official. Here's your finishing results, presented by ESPN. Dylan Pozzi with the win. RJ Bishop second. 30 in Dunna, 4th Mesa Powers, 5th Jessica Shelton, 6th Anthony Ritchie, 7th Zach Flickinger, 8th James Qualls, 9th JT Bryant, and like I mentioned, Zachary Fitzwater got a top 10 finish, edging out Levi McIntyre in 11th. DJ Curtis, 12th. Seth Cole, didn't even talk about him or William Duncan at all, or Chris Washer, top 15 runs for him. Chris Washer, fun fact, before this season, that was his last race that he won in that 35 car, so that's crazy to know that we didn't even talk about him. He got a good, consistent run there. Quint Spillman got 16th, Kyle Miller 17th, Charles Sanford 18th, Michael Walton 19th, and Johnny Garner just got a top 20 right there. And then the rest of the cars finished the lead lap. Connor Meyer, Cody Lamas, and Paul Barber in 23rd. Lap down cars including Trent Dunham, Austin Mungo, Michael Norman, Alex May, Zach Rogers. That's a big name right there, top 10 in points. I don't know if we'll have enough to be in the All-Star race, but we shall see later on at the end of the video. Keith Batson, Kyle Keith, Caleb Paris, Steve Hawley III, Alex Ferranzi, and Tanner Sullivan, the last car to finish the race overall. And then previously mentioned, out of the race, Kev Shear, Brett Pritchard, Jack Tang, Anthony McCurry, Devin Becker, Kyle Matthews, Angel Navarro, and Sky Commons, the hometown hero, will come away sadly in dead last. Well, thank you guys for watching this race. Be sure to give it a like if you enjoyed it. Comment your thoughts. The subscribe part of the NRSL by hitting that subscribe button. First off, I want to thank Zach Rogers for joining me in the booth. That was a lot of fun that we had, and glad you got to see such an exciting race.
Yeah, it was a blast up here with you, Dylan. Hopefully you can come back to Florida with me as we get ready for the NRSL Mountain Dew for the Win Cup Series and the NRSL Aces Republic of Gamers Truck Series starting up here shortly. Hopefully you can come to Florida for some great racing action with me here shortly.
Oh, of course. If you want to check out Zach's channel, it's Bulldog Speed. Get Bulldog Speed right here, and the link will be down below in the description. And hopefully you'll sub to his channel and all that stuff. Till then, goodbye everybody from Las Vegas, and I'll give more details about the All-Star race and all that stuff in a minute, but you'll see who is in the top 10 in points. If you are top 10, no matter what, you're going to be going getting a golden ticket to the All-Star race. So until then, if you don't make it, you're in the showdown. We say farewell from Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Dylan Pote got himself into the jackpot going to victory lane, and we will see you guys later at Coca-Cola. Till then, goodbye everybody. I believe Zach Rogers' final words of wisdom.
Peace out.
See you later, guys.